the Lord is my shepherd cannot be a joke. It's an explanation to how God originally makes somebody wealthy. There are seven wealth schemes that I would like to discuss right now. And it will be useful that you take notes, because then you are able to decipher or detect in your life when these things begin to show up. The very first of the known wealth schemes of God, God's alternate to wealth, is what's called scholarship and sponsorship. That is the kind of wealth that somebody else is responsible for paying your bill. It is the kind of blessing, or it's the kind of wealth that will precipitate that somebody else is responsible for paying your bill. So when you read Isaiah 49 and verse 22, it says, I will beckon to the Gentiles. They will carry your sons upon their hands. Their kings will carry your sons on their hands, their daughters, your daughters on their shoulder. He then said, he said, the kings will be your sons' foster parents and their queens, your children's nursing mother. Yes.
That's correct.
I will do this, they will lick the dust off your feet so I can demonstrate that I have put my splendor on you.
Amen.
If you are planning to live with a wealth scheme today that is diametrically opposed to cash, that it's not a schemish kind of wealth scheme, it's the one that is what's called a true wealth scheme, take note, because we're going to ask, you're going to ask God that if these things be, can I have one? Can I have some of this? So there's, I said scholarship, sponsorship and scholarship. The second one is indirect wealth. By that I mean what is popularly known as wealth by transfer. Is the one that they said that it's indirect, because Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 10 and 11 says that you will be brought into a land, a city of houses that you did not build, filled with goodly things that you did not fill, wells you did not dig, olive groves and plantations that you did not plant. That is indirect wealth. Indirect wealth because you didn't really have anything to do with it. Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 6 says that you will feed or eat on the wealth of the nations. In their riches, you will boast. I am talking about if you spoke to God and you said cash is not king, what were we supposed to depend on? I'm talking about seven wealth schemes that exist as I speak on this planet that you're not concentrating on. You're looking at the exchange mechanism. That one thing you've never known about cash is that cash is king and people hunt for it. And after the end of their search, they never seem to have got it. They seem they have got it, but they suddenly is moved away, and all you have is a lifetime of wages, wage slips, to prove that you were running. You think you have got it, you think you are about to get it, but you never seem to get enough of it. All you have is a lot of pay slips and receipts to the fact that you are running all your life. They call godliness and religion the opium of the masses. I think it's misconstrued. I think they're wrong. I think God, cash is king. Cash is God, and people have been deluded by it. If God doesn't give you a wealth scheme, you will join them. So you need indirect wealth. And the third one, and I'll begin to explain this right now, is overflow. Overflow is when wealth, God gives you a wealth that overwhelms, it's wealth by overwhelming. It's the kind of wealth that you have that it will be too much for your enemy. It will overtake whatever your enemy is doing.
Amen.
Amos chapter 9 and verse 13 says you will be blessed beyond the curse. So if you are blessed by God, what God will do is he will send you something, one of his wealth schemes called overflow. That overflow will make sure that your cup runs over, and whatever the devil is doing, it won't show, because you will have more things in your fridge.
Amen.
Than the things that is getting, that is frustrating you. You will have more things that God is giving you that it will not show what the devil is doing. The woman of Zarephath, the widow of Zarephath, the Bible says God gave her oil, that at the end of the oil, when it finished paying the debt, there was even much more for her to even make money out of.
Hallelujah.
There is something called wealth by overflow.
Mm.
And if God decides to give you that, well, no matter what the devil is doing in your life, it won't show. Because the number one job of the devil is he's come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. His job is to make delinquent or absent what God is doing. When I said wealth scheme, wealth is whatever you have that is a lot. What the devil does, so a lot of anything. If your wealth is your allotment, your wealth is your allocation, your wealth is your lottery. But what the devil tries to do is he tries to take out so that people will not see that you have a lot. He tries to hunt down what you have done, what God has given to you. And when the enemy overtakes you, it begins to be obvious that it looks as if you have never been blessed. You look as if you are poor. And it's not. It's just as if what the blessing you had was not enough. That's why it didn't show. What about Romans chapter 5 and verse 20? When he says that where iniquity has abounded, grace will abound much more. Romans chapter 8 and verse 37 says that you are blessed beyond, you are like more than a conqueror. It means that you are conquered, but you're gone beyond that. God can make you go beyond even conquering. I'm talking about if God was going to give you something that will not be called cash, but that it will be more mighty than cash. Because the problem with cash is not cash does not answer everything. If you put cash before cancer, if you put cash before a raging storm, if you put cash, loads of cash, in front of a natural disaster, so you need the anointing of an overflow. The fourth wealth scheme I would like to talk about today is something called anointing, and forget what you think anointing is. Anointing is wealth by multi-talenting you. Anointing is when you have, when God multi-layers you. It comes from an idea called, have you ever heard of something called plywood? When God multiplies you. Plywood is a series of wood, many wood upon each other. What that does is that when God multi-talents you, you have, there's no amount of what the enemy is doing. If he's trying to stop that, you do that. If he's trying to stop that, you're doing that. If he's trying to stop that, you do this. Are you with me today? You have to tell God to multi-layer you today. You're going to have to tell God to multi-anoint you today, because is one of the wealth schemes of God. When God makes you more than what the devil can stop. Because there were four wealth streams, wealth rivers that came into Eden. So if the devil stopped one river, there was another river. If he stopped one river, there was another river. It's only at our world understanding that they say you're only good for one thing. It's in the world that say that you're here to become a carpenter, you are actually a doctor. All you are is a lawyer. The devil is a liar. When God gives you a gift, it's like me. You're not just a head. When God gives you a gift, he gives you a body of gifts. You've got hands, you've got feet, you've got legs, you've got eyes, you've got... When God gives you a gift, he gives you, I am an example of what God means by blessing. When God means by, what he means by anointing. Anointing is that you have so many things that that makes you up.
Amen.
You've got so many things that you are made up of. If you forget what anointing is, look at your body. So they say in Acts of Apostles chapter 9 and chapter 10 and verse 38, the Bible says how Jesus Christ was anointed with Holy Ghost and power. And he went about doing good. So if you say was just a political person, you can't say he was just a preacher. You can't say he was just a teacher. You won't say he was just a healer. You won't say he was somebody who was a very excellent teacher. He was multi-anointed. He was multi-sided and complicated. You couldn't stop him. The hand of the
biggest.
I'm trying to, you know, when I started, I said cash is king, and God doesn't like it. Most people didn't know what does he know what he's talking about. I'm telling you that I've been told to tell you that if you look for another king, if you want God to be your master, and you say if you don't want me to depend on cash, What do I depend on? I am giving you the list of things that you should look for. Because Isaiah chapter 61 and verse 1 says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me. Why? He has anointed me to preach the good news, one, the same anointing to heal the brokenhearted, two, to comfort those who mourn in Zion, three. It's the same anointing that has anointed me so that I can preach the good news. I can walk upon water. It's the same anointing. It wasn't one thing. He had multi-layered you.
Amen.
Okay. Come on now. So the fourth one was overflow. The third one was overflow. The fourth one was anointing. You say to your neighbor, please, can you say something unique about me? Can you say to your neighbor, is there something unique about me? Is there something that's more than one thing about me? Am I just a pastor in your eye? Am I just an administrator in your eye? Is all I'm good for is a carpenter? Do I just go to NHS? Am I just a worker in Tesco? Because if the devil wants to destroy you, he'll make you one thing and then he makes it easy for him to cut you off. One of the reasons why there's not a lot of rich people or blessed people in the body of Christ is that the devil has sold them the idea that they're just one thing.
Yeah.
And when you're one thing, you don't have enough. You know, the only time that the anointing ran out in the room of the widow of Zarephath was when she said she ran out of
pots.
Because she didn't get the idea that if you want to be multi-layered and multi-complicated and multi-sided and very many, you have to make sure that go and borrow the pot. Go and loan the pot. Just go and get it. Because I want the more I can put so that in rainy days will come, I will still have more. Because if that one runs out and I'm paying my bills with that, I'm paying my mortgage with that one, I'm paying the car MOT with that pot, I'm using that pot to pay for my kids' school fees. That way, there are so many pots and you're not depending on one job. You have to tell God that he has to anoint you so that you are many-sided and you are hard to chop off. Okay. Amen.
Amen.
The fifth thing I like to talk about is that life as wealth. Life as wealth. Matthew chapter 6 and verse 25 says that is life not more than a body? Is life not more than a body, and a life more, not more than the food you put in the body, and your body not more than the clothes that you put on it? In verse 27, what the Bible says is that how can a man add one single hour to his life? If you are rich in the world and God doesn't give you time to spend it, you know it's a waste. So life is a wealth scheme. God can give you life. Health is a wealth scheme. Information is a wealth scheme. When God gives you an idea of business that he hasn't given anybody else, when God gives you an idea of how you eat so that you're not eating poisonous food, and God gives you the secret of vegan dieting and stop taking wrong rubbish things in your tummy, God is giving you wealth. It's another kind of wealth. It's a wealth scheme. Because it's better God keeps you alive so that even the little you have is spent.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
If cash is not king, what will be the alternative?
Amen.
What is the alternative if cash is not king? Life as wealth. Information is wealth. Health is wealth. The Bible says, how I wish that you prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospers. Don't stop looking at that thing made out of paper. They're not real wealth. Number six is beautification. I discovered that Solomon could not replicate the kind of design of material of clothing that's on the lily. As rich as Solomon was, he couldn't design an apparel to wear that was of the same topology as a lily in the bush. With all the money that he had, it was impossible for him to replicate that.